Hey everybody, this is Not a Spring Chick, and the news, I mean, talk about finance. Okay, see, part of it is we all know that Cyprus has been having problems, and of course, Europe is following its ways because, you know, the way to get the economy going, of course, is just to take money out of people's banks. Or so they thought! Okay, what in the world are they thinking? Anyway, we're seeing repercussions coming out all throughout Europe, and we're going to bring Oldecam on with comments and the headlines of today to talk more about this and other news.
My glasses from the company that gave me the glasses. Actually, I don't often get glasses.
I know. So Cyprus starts a financial trend.
Oh, yeah. They said it's going, they're already, okay, they're shutting banks down in every single country that has a problem that's going bankrupt. You know, the Spanish government is shutting the banks down, the Italian, the Greeks, the Portuguese, the Irish. And they're because they don't want to run on the banks, because everyone knows the idea now is that the governments will seize the assets of all of the wealthy in their countries to pay the bill. It gives them a new source of revenue. Well, they can't raise taxes any higher than they're raising them, so we're just going to seize all the money in the banks. Well, what happens is every bank other than the ones in Cyprus know that that's coming, so the people are basically going to make nothing but runs on their banks, which basically brings every single country down in a domino.
Well, I know, and then they're talking about charging people to take their money out of banks.
Yeah, in order to withdraw your money, it's going to cost you 6% of the money that you have in the bank to withdraw it.
Well, guess what happens? People aren't going to put money in banks.
The banks are not going to get any money back. The Russians, they said the Russians are cooperating. Well, no, they're not. This morning, Vladimir Putin and Medvedev are very vocal. What was it? Asshole? They said the asshole Merkel? Mm-hmm. Basically, they were not very happy because she dreamed us up to collapse every bank in Europe and keep the... The problem is they want to throw her out in Germany. She's lost a coalition government. She's there until the next election, and then they throw her butt out because she's basically spent all of the money that they had in order to try to take over these countries. And the last one is the Putin. I mean, certainly, you know. Well, you know, what is it, Stuart Varney and what's his name? The people over at Fox. Well, this is never going to come to the United States. Mm-hmm. Barack Obama was supporting the actions in Europe to seize the assets of the wealthy because they're not paying their fair share in taxes. So it's coming here, folks.
And Obama brokers an Israel-Turkey rapprochement.
Supposedly, they're trying to figure out what Netanyahu got from Obama to apologize for killing people that basically threw a grenade into his people and opened up on them with guns. They said he must have got something big under the table. And the problem is that what Obama does not understand is just, I was watching a thing that my father was in, and I was in both, but we did two different things, called the Battle of Bulge. And one of the lines was about the massacres, was simply, no matter how many people you kill, no matter how much material you destroy about what happens, there's always something left that's going to blow the whistle on you. And you don't think that Netanyahu has his version of Benghazi, which the Senate Democrats have? He will blow the whistle on this president if he thinks it's to his advantage.
And Karl Rove sees Republicans supporting gay rights.
Yeah, and this morning, let's see, what was it? Let's see, Glenn Beck, Rush Limbaugh, Sean Hannity, and most of the people out there, basically, you can't win the election with Democrat support. Said, yeah, hell's going to freeze over when the Republicans support gay rights. This morning, they already blew the whistle on Roberts, and they're getting ready to hand Roberts his head. He has been discussing things with one of his gay relatives about overturning the rules. Yeah, which means he must excuse himself, and they're going to force him off, which means the best the Democrats can get is a 4-4 tie, which means every single thing stands. This is not. They said they've worked out every single way that things could go, plus and con, and didn't come up with the fact that a justice having to excuse themselves would basically throw it into a disaster.
Palestinian hunger striker exiled to Gaza.
Well, you know, they just get rid of them. That's how they handle troublemakers, is you dump them because...
Oh, that's how you do it?
Oh, yeah. You know, like the BS said, that's... You know, you don't kill them, you just dump them to where they're not wanted.
And nations gather for final UN arms trade treaty negotiations.
Oh yeah, Obama's going to sell out our country. But the whole problem is that he won't, as he couldn't do it before, he's going to try to do it without the permission of Congress of the United States. It said the President of the United States may take part in negotiating treaties, but only the Congress of the United States, specifically the Senate, has the ability to pass it. They said it will never, a thing that basically turns our arms industry over to the United Nations will never get through. You think they can't get an assault weapon ban? What do you think the chances are the Senate of the United States voting to turn our entire industry over to, that would be Lockheed, that would be Boeing, that would be Smith & Wesson, that would be the people that built General Electric, who builds our Every military thing that uses weapons would be turned over to the United Nations to control.
Japan Prime Minister Abe's Pacific Trade Pact gambit pays off for now.
Yeah, but they said it was okay. They're doing everything short term. Short term means that they got to pay the bills. It's like Obama's thing. Well, I'm not going to worry about it. We'll let the people down the line worry about the deficit. Well, that's what they're doing in Japan, and that's not how Japanese. Government works. They are concerned about bills now, not bills 10 years from now.
Oh, you mean like most people?
Yeah.
They're trying to...
The Japanese government, Japan used to have the highest savings rate in the world because...
Used to think long term.
Yeah, but no, the politicians are thinking short term. The people are saying, don't do it. See, what happens is he's replacing the guy who spent money they didn't have, who was replacing the guy that spent money they didn't have, who replaced the guy who spent money they didn't have.
I can always help people spend money they don't have.
And this is what the new one wants to do. Well, I'm gambling that this will work and that we'll have the money to pay back that I'm doing. Yeah, that's the same reason they bust the last four.
Mm. And Sarah Palin tells conservatives to branch out.
Yeah, they've got it. Okay. Basically, there was a difference between fiscal conservative and social conservatism. She's a fiscal conservative that basically thinks that that we have went too far to the left in a lot of areas. And okay, first of all, I'm going to tell you what B.S. DeBull says. You don't give a rat's ass about the people that are here illegally. You want the people that are here that did it the hard way. They're your constituency. The people that are here illegally are socialists, folks. They're going to vote Democratic no matter what. And since they can't legally vote, you know, they're basically finding out that Obama actually didn't win the election, and a lot of senators and representatives didn't win the election because seems that almost all the illegal votes were done by Democrats, for Democrats.
And Palestinians cool to partial settlement freeze.
Well, yeah, because that was Obama's idea of a partial settlement freeze. That never had a chance of going anywhere. But, what she thinks that, well, you're going to have to compromise. Well, yeah, putting the enemy in your backyard is a compromise.
That's a compromise, yeah. And Israeli military responds to fire from Syria.
Yeah, they fired back at it. But the problem is, it's not the Syrians doing the firing. It's those Obama's starting to get the idea. We got to worry about the radicalization. There are now more radicals in Syria than there are people fighting against the government on the opposition side. So, well, there's so many of them that the person that was nominated to handle the opposition government resigned yesterday.
Hmm. An art world shivers at sale of Henry Moore statue.
Well, I know, because, statues are meant to be sold.
Why? So, did it sell for a lot?
Sold for a lot.
A new pope opens Holy Week at Vatican on Palm Sunday.
Yeah, well, it's his job. They're all supposed to do that. But he's done something different.
What did he do?
He's going to where the people have no money and can't afford to, you know, they can't afford to go to the big fancy churches. So he's going to them, which means, something smells. Because when his pope goes into areas, it looks like the PR campaign.
Oh, I would probably say so. And a Monty bubbleism from the Mark Twain of the Animal Kingdom.
Okay. When you think that taking somebody's money out of their pocket is going to make those people happy you did it, you must be a Democrat.